सो हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू माय चैनल टेक्निकल निकी। सो एज वी आर ऑन दी सीरीज दैट इज दी फंक्शंस इन सी प्लस प्लस, एंड इन दी लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट देम, फंक्शंस इन सी प्लस प्लस। इफ यू डिडंट वॉच दी लास्ट वीडियो सो डोंट वरी, लिंक इज अवेलेबल इन दी डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स, सो गो देयर एंड वॉच दी वीडियो। ओके, सो दैट इज दी यूजर डिफाइंड फंक्शंस, एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट दी यूजर डिफाइंड फंक्शन दैट यूजर कैन use the user defined function or create them for this himself, for make his code easy and consume his time, for the save his time. Okay, so a user can create the multiple functions or the for avoid the repetitions of the same code again and again. Okay, he can use the user defined function like that, my function. Okay, and if you want to make addition, then you can use the add function and you can give it name for the functions. Okay, so create a user defined function, we have to do something that function prototype and the more things. So there are the three steps for use or create a user defined function, that are the first is function prototype and the function definition and then function call. Okay, so now in this video I will explain about the functions, function prototype. Okay, about this one. So what is the function prototype? Okay, let me just raise this. So function prototype, so function prototype, in the function prototype we have to declare about the function type and the function name and the function argument and the parameters and the terminating semicolons. So it means function type, we have to declare the type of the function, int, float, character or the etc. And the function name, you can give any name according to your need. If you want to make addition, then you can give add and the multiplication formula, subtraction, subtraction for sub, and the division like that, and the my function or the void main function, something like that you can use any name according to you. Okay, and the function argument, a function argument is depends on the user how many arguments you are needed inside a function, that the 2, 4, 5, 6 2, 3, 1, 4 as you want. Okay, so a function argument is depends on the user, and this is the terminating semicolon. After the end of this function, we use this semicolon for terminate the functions. Okay, and this is the syntax of a function, that is the function type. First we have to declare the function type, then the function name and the function arguments, args means arguments, and the terminate by the semicolon. Here is its example int, and here function type is integer and function name is addition, and the function argument int x and the int y, you can use int z and the more. Okay, and I have terminated it with the semicolon. So let's take a look on the example or the program of the function prototype. So as here, okay, wait. As we here, I have a function that is the int mul, and it means multiplication. And function type is integer, and the function name is mul, and the function argument is two arguments inside the function. Okay, and int x and the int y, and I have terminated it by the semicolon. Okay, or you can terminate in semicolon, but make sure that you have outside of the int main function, then when you have to terminate it by the semicolon. And okay, after that, what is the function call? Function call, I have created this function and the some code inside the function. Okay, the 3 lines of code, and when I call this code, as I here I print out this, print this code, this shout function mul x and comma y, that are the arguments inside the function. So here I will no need to repeat this again and again. I will only use this mul x comma y for print these, for execute the same code for we use the function for the write once and run the so many times. Okay, write once and run so many times, okay. So here if I execute this program, now it will here function return, then it print solve this equation inside the function MUL. It means this, okay. So it will solve this equation, and first it asking for the enter the first value and then enter the second value. So let's go ahead. What this program is from the last video. If you watch the last video, then you can understand it what about I am talking. So just execute the program, and here it will ask for the first value. Just wait. Okay, wait. Just make it clear. Now execute this again. Okay, what's happening with this? Okay, execute the program. Enter the first value. If I enter the first value to 10 and the second value to 5, it the function return 50, because if we multiply 10 to 5 times, it returns 50, because here we are doing the, performs the multiplication operator between the two arguments. Okay, so I hope you understand the function prototype in C++. If you have any problem, comment me down, I will solve it out, okay, for you. So I hope guys you enjoy the video. If the video is helpful for you, so please guys give it big thumbs up, and if you are new on my channel, so make it subscribe for never miss any future updates. So thank you guys, thanks for watching again and again, and I will see you in the next time.